Hello everyone, welcome back to aetatsplus.com. Once again, this is Gottfried Karl Heinrich Hofmann from Robco Pictures speaking. And today we're gonna create a candle with a volumetric flame in Blender 2.4 beta. And the reason we can do this is because the smoke simulation in Blender has received quite some attention lately, and so there was a patch created that added a lot of cool new features and that also eliminated a few of the problems I had shown you in the earlier tutorials about the smoke simulation. So very cool stuff going on. And the smoke patch was mainly created by a guy named Mika, who also originally created this candle flame scene. And well, it was practically a demonstration on the new features, because they're specifically useful if you want to create small, or let's say defined objects, smoke objects that don't have too much noise, or that are not big but rather small, like for example a small flame of a candle or a burning match or a cigarette smoke. That's all stuff you can do right now with the new add-ons. And yeah, I'm also using a candle for the demonstration because, well, that's what works best, or that's what's the best subject to show you all the new cool new stuff that you can get with the new patch. And the patch is incorporated in the latest beta version 2.54. Which means if you grab it from the official Blender homepage or a latest build from GraphicAll, it's already integrated. And before we start building the scene, let me show you around on the final product. It's very, very simple actually. We just got this candle, our domain, some light, because the smoke simulation can't cast light by itself right now, so we need to fake it using a Blender light. Some wind to make the candle flame move a little bit, to give it a little more realism and a little life. And well, if you wonder where the emitter is, it's not in the wick, but beyond. Let me see. Here it is. And the reason why we're using it this way, you will see why we're working on the flame later on, because this will be a project where we are gonna try to create the flame on the traditional way. We created the other flames in the earlier tutorials, and then we might see that it's not the best way always, and so we'll choose a different way, a different setup of the texture for the flame. And yeah, there's also some compositing involved this time. It's rather simple, but it involves different render layers. And you'll also see a little tip on setting up render layers when you work with the smoke simulation, because if you do it wrong, you might lose all your data, all your baked data for your simulation. But well, let's start. Well, here we are inside Blender with our default scene, and well, let's first get rid of the cube by hitting X and delete. And now let's hit Shift A to add a mesh, and it's a circle from which we're gonna extrude. And to get a simple topology, let's reduce the vertices to 12. And now, yeah, I'm gonna zoom in a little, and now I'm hitting E to extrude. Oh, first I'm going to go into edit mode, hit E to extrude, set to keep it on the set axis, and yeah, I guess, yeah, that's about right, maybe a little more. And now we should have somewhat candle size. And well, let's hit E once again, and once again keep it on the set axis. Let's extrude just a little bit. And then hit E once again, this time S to scale it in. But not that much. E again, set this time downwards. And E again, S to scale, and let's close it in quite a bit. And yeah, once again, should I? Yeah, let's add a second ring on the inside to get a planar surface. And yeah, and this is where we're gonna add the wick in a second. Now what I'm gonna do is set the shading to smooth, and you'll see that the normals are quite messed up, so let's go back into edit mode, select everything by hitting A, this time twice because first I had to deselect stuff and now I can reselect everything. And now let's hit Control N, and this should recalculate normals. Yeah, seems to be quite right. Let's see what happens if we add. Now we're back in object mode, and let's see what happens if we add a subsurf modifier. Actually, you can do this by going to the modifiers panel and then add modifier and choose the subsurf modifier. Or there's a shortcut to it because the subsurf modifier is used so often that you can access it directly by pressing Control and 2. Yeah. But if you want to make changes, you still need to go to the modifier panels, for example, if you want to increase the number of subdivisions in the view and the render. And yeah, that's actually what I just did. And yeah, the normals are quite correctly. Yeah, I don't think we need to do anything on the bottom of the candle, and yeah, actually, I don't think we need to do quite a lot with this because this should be a very simple model. What I'm gonna do now is will create the wick, and so let me select this loop in the middle. I did this by using Alt and right click. And well, I'm gonna scale it in just a little more, about that much. And now I'm gonna hit E to extrude again, hit set, and just a little bit until this is going upwards a little, because this will be the place where the wax is soaked into the lid, into the wick, and we have some surface tension at this point, so we need to create this little bump. Well, and now hit E to extrude once again on the Z axis. And now, yeah, well, let's get up and let's see how this looks currently. Yeah, actually, the wick is never straight upwards once it has start burning, but it's a little twisted and bent. So, yeah, let's just build this very simple. Hit R to rotate. And yeah, G to move this a little bit, maybe in this direction. But if we extrude now, we should be able to extrude it in a way that it's yeah, somewhat bent. And yeah, I'd also say that we ought to decrease the size. So hit S to scale and decrease it just a little bit. And let me also decrease the size here a little so the wick becomes smaller at the tip. And yeah, let's see. Actually, this is somewhat 2D currently how the wick is created, because yeah, it's just we had to adjust two dimensions on our field where we hit G and the viewport. So let me rotate around this a little bit, just slightly, and now let's move the wick a little more. So go back into edit mode, and now here we can hit G and maybe somewhere in this direction, just a little bit of moving around. Or here with G a little bit, just that. So now we got a small bit of the third dimension in the twisting and bending of the wig. And yeah, I think that's enough. So yeah, I'll hit E to extrude once again, extrude it but just a very little bit. And now I'll go to the menu Mesh, Vertical Matrices, and Merge at Center. And if you see a tactical tip of the wig now, it has the vertices merged at the center. And you see a lot of triangles, which is usually not that good when you're doing subsurface modeling, but in this case, it's okay because yeah, it's the tip of the wig and it's always a little brushed out or grunged or how you call it. Well, I think we might add a loop cut here. You can do this by hitting Ctrl R. And now let's slide upwards to remove the, to make the wig not so. Yeah, the triangles had added artifacts, and which we want only at the tip and not everywhere else. So now things should be quite good. Yeah, yeah, that's okay. We won't see much of the wig anyways. And yeah, now the next thing is let's add some materials to it. And yeah, practically we need just two of the one for the wax, for the candle, and one for the wig. And well, in Blender 2.5 you now got the possibility to add several materials to just one object. This is new, and let me show how. Let me show you how. Well, first let's go into object mode and add a simple material. Let's call it wax, and let's not do anything with it right now, but go into edit mode. Let's select this loop, and now let's hit Control and plus on the keyboard, which practically selects more. Ah, I think we need to select it differently. We need to select this loop at the top. And now let's hit Control plus, select more, and once again more, and now we got everything selected that we need. And now let's add a new material here. Make it a single user because currently it's a linked copy of the wax. And now let's call it wig. Change the color, black. I'll change it to about nearly black and clear hit assign. And now see our wig is pitch black. Ah, and we see something else. Practically we need to add another edge loop right here. So Control R. And now get it down. And now also our black color will go down. So let's see where we want to have the where we want the wig to start. And I say, right about here. Ah, that's not quite enough, I think. So let's hit G and move it down once again a little bit more. So here. Yeah, maybe this way. Now we need to work on the materials, of course. Even though when the candle does not burn, the wick has some specularity, but of course no speck inside the flame. So let's remove it nearly and increase the hardness still. So maybe we'll see a little bit of the at the tip of the wick of the specularity, but not much. And yeah, I think the diffuse color is quite right, and everything else too. Yeah, that's pretty much okay. So we can work on the wax material now. Basically, let's just render this. I'll hit, before I tell you how to set up the WEX. I want to render it to show you why I'm doing this. And while this is a camera fly mode, very cool, hit Shift and F. Well, when you're in camera mode and you can actually fly around with it like you would do in a 3D shooter game like Descent or something. Okay, that's not the final camera position, but we can choose this, use this to render it. And also, let me first change the position of this light here more or less to the top. So, let's hit G and position it right at the top of this. And now let's go back into camera mode and render the image. You see? It's the material of the candle is looking very much like plastic, and we want it to look like wax. So we need something that's called subsurface scattering. But before that, let me do a few changes to the setup. Let's make the horizon black. And in the world panel, let's also add a bit of environment lighting, like 0.1, just a little bit. And also let's add ambient occlusion for hitting to multiply. And now let's see how it's looking right now. First I'm gonna save, and now let me render this. Yeah, so this is how it's looking right now. Everything is just like plastic, and now let's see what's gonna happen when we change the material, the wax material, to have subsurface scattering enabled. So we're gonna enable it, and let's choose one of those presets. Let's go with skimmed milk, and now let's hit F12 again, and rendering will take a little longer now, but yeah, quite some difference, right? And yeah, when you're doing skin, you got a problem in CG either. Without subsurface scattering, it's looking like plastic. And if you use it, and you use the wrong settings, it looks like wax. But we don't have a problem with that, obviously, because we want to look the things. We want things to look like wax. So yeah, everything is fine. And actually, I don't want to go into much detail here because there are enough tutorials out there on how to use subsurface scattering. So let's just keep it at skim milk, and it's about okay. It's a little waxy already. And now let's get on. Yeah, actually we have set up our entire candle. It's modeled completely, so let's go on to the next step and add a smoke system to it. Well, now let's set up our smoke simulation for the candle flame. First we're gonna add the domain, and this can be done by hitting Shift A and adding a cube. Now we're gonna hit T and set to bring it up, or bring it into position. And now we need to scale it inside object mode and not in edit mode. Otherwise the voxel data texture will mess up later on. So let's hit S to scale it, and this time Shift set. This means it will be scaled on X and Y axis, but not on the Z axis. On let's scale it about inside this here. And now let's see. I guess that should be quite correct. Let's hit Z to see. It's inside the candle, and the wick is also completely inside our domain. So that's perfectly okay. So now head over to the physics panel and choose smoke at domain, and now we can see through it, and it's become our domain for the smoke system. And yeah, We are gonna use a resolution of 64 on this one. And now let's have a look at the new options we got here. The first new option is the scale factor. And this can be used to make the simulation slower, so you got a effect of slow movement of the fire. This is comes in very handy when you get multiple simulations going and you want to fake it that one is very far away and the other one is very near, because the one that's farther away can have a reduced scale, so it looks like it's moving slower. And by increasing the resolution on that domain, you'll also get finer detail. And so, yeah, that's a very good way to fake the impression of one smoke being near and the other far away when doing a complicated composite. And another good idea is to make things faster, and we're gonna use this because the candle flame, of course, is burning quite fast. Usually you can see it, but the movement is very fast, and when you get wind it will be very somewhat twitching, and so we need a very fast simulation. And yeah, the maximum for the scale is 1.5, by the way. You can't cheat on it, so even if you set the values higher manually, it will be 1.5 will be the maximum. And the other new setting is the so-called vorticity. And what's that? Practically, it's the your smoke simulation has a lot of turbulence in it normally, and by reducing the vorticity, you can reduce the amount of turbulence in your smoke simulation. So when you want to fake a very big explosion and a big fire and a lot of smoke is emitting, you need a lot of turbulence, of course. But when you only want a very small fire, like the fire of a candle flame, it wouldn't look realistic if they well, so much turbulence as in a really big fire or a burning building or something. So we need to reduce the vorticity to a very low level. And yeah, actually I reduced it to the lowest level possible for the candle flame, and that's 0.01. You can't get any lower. And well, the other settings are the same as usual, you notice. We will need to have our smoke dissolve, because this is I have told you already, this is a feature to fake the missing fuel option, and I guess the time of 7 or let's say 8 might be correct. And of course slow, and we'll make a very handy use of the slow feature later on. And in the border collisions, you can have now vertically open, which means at the top and at the bottom the smoke can get out of your domain, or you can have it completely open, which will reduce some problems that might occur if you're using wind. And so actually I choose it to be completely open, because we're gonna add a wind system later on and I don't want to run into trouble. And well, now let's add the emitter, and the emitter will just be a simple plane, so the smoke won't be emitted from the wick, because that will make things unnecessarily complicated. And I've tried to work with smoke coming from the wick, but it wasn't any better, and it was a lot of it was actually a lot more difficult to set up to make it look good. And so to make life easier, let's just add a simple plane as an emitter. And yeah, the plane, let's hit once again G and set and move it upwards, so right about at the very bottom of the wick at first. And now let's hit S to scale it. Actually, I'm gonna hit 7 first to get into a top view. And now hit S to scale it, and I'm scaling it. Of course, it must be smaller than the domain, and yeah, it will define the size of our candle flame, and I guess, yeah, that's, this is about right. And now we want to add a subsurf modifier, control 2, very easy. Let's increase the level to 3. And yeah, let's check the modifiers panel and apply it. And now we got a somewhat circular shape for our emitter. Which is, well, it's a little much on the bottom. Let's hit T, set, and go up to, yeah, but just where the wick starts for now. And yeah, of course, the emitter needs a particle system. We already know that. And for the amount of particles, I'll choose quite a lot to get a decent distribution, so the smoke will come from everywhere on the plane. And well, let's see the, how they are looking. Actually, we don't need any physics to do this. We won't render the emitter and we won't render the particles. But in a display, let's choose point and see how they're looking. And yeah, we got an emitter that's practically, it's filled with particles. And yeah, it, let's make it end at to 50. And yeah, a lifetime of 50 is actually about right, because we want this to have some particles should die and some particles should live, because the flame should have a little bit of, there should be a little bit of randomness in the flame to make it more lifelike. Oh, let's choose a lifetime of the particles of 100, which should reduce problems later on. And yeah, it takes a while till our flame will start to burn as it should, but yeah, that should not be a problem, because we can set our if we set the start to minus 100, the particles begin this way, but that's not so good, because this will make our flame start somewhat, the start of our flame when it starts burning will be a little hefty and you'll get quite some bulb. So let's choose 1 again as a starting point. And now let's head over to the physics panel and add smoke to our emitter 2, but this time flow. And now see, the particle system we've just added has already been added to the, it's already chosen. And that's something very cool about a revamped smoke system. It was one step, you always had to choose a particle system, and if there's only one, it of course doesn't make any sense if you need to choose it anyways. So this saves you a little time, and it was one of the criticisms I had earlier on when I said that the handling of the smoke system should be streamlined, because I guess a lot of time is saved if people don't need to manually add the particle system in the flow settings when they when things could be automated that easily. And yeah, here's also a few new options. At first, when you hit initial velocity, which we won't, you have a multiplier here. And you might think, why should I have this multiplier when I got my particle system set up and I inherit the velocity from the particles? I can change the velocity of the particles. But this is one thing, once again, to get around the problem that the blender that the blender smoke simulation doesn't have a fuel option. And one of the ideas, for example, if you create a normal flamethrower, so not like the one I've shown you earlier in my tutorials, but a typical one with some burning gas. Yeah, it's gas in English. And when that burns, usually the particles in your simulation would be the gas, and your flame, when it would burn, it would massively slow down once it burns, but the gas would shoot out farther. And to work on this multiplayer setting is one of the ideas here we have in Blender to fake the missing fuel simulation, because we don't need have the actual slowdown, but the fire will actually start slower if you set this. So yeah, I don't think many people will need this, but it's cool it's there, and actually we won't do anything this with this. Maybe in another tutorial. And another thing here is a new checkbox for so-called absolute density. And what's that doing? Actually, if you check absolute density, the behavior will be exactly like it was before. And if you uncheck it, you now have the density you see here will be added over time. So your emitter will add density over time, while before it was that everywhere on the emitter there were particles. They are just in those parts of the domain, just this density that was set here was allowed. And now the density can add up over time, which means practically, yeah, you can smooth out your emitter, which was also a problem before. Usually you had this blocky emitter, and this is one way to smooth it out. So we are gonna check this and start with an density of maybe 0.2. We're gonna see later on if this makes any sense. And yeah, we are right up. It's right about time to start baking, so let's choose the smoke cache. And yeah, let's bake just 150 frames, and let me set up the cache first, the low resolution cache, and also the animation time should be reduced to 150 now. And yeah, let's save, and oh yeah, hit bake all diamond dynamics, which will bake both particles and our smoke simulation.